I want big windows, high ceilings, large kitchen, garden, big, big garden, maybe a wood fire or an arga. So it's got to be a house.
No, it's got to be a home.
That's right. A home. My first real home.
Then relax, because for 3% commission, I can make all your dreams come true.
Boys are back in town. And girlies, of course.
Okay, a moment of focus. Now, apart from burying a close relative, what's the second most stressful thing people ever have to do in their lives?
Enter the housing market.
Right, so Mr. Collier Bryan wants us to take our frightened and panicky clients and make sure that becomes the first. Because fear is the word.
Jaunty.
Fear is good.
Phoebe.
Fear works.
Mel.
Fear is the key to the door.
It's what makes buyers buy and sellers sell. Fear is what keeps us in business. So let's get in there and give a new place some nightmares. Where the shit is he?
And this is on the market for what?
900,000.
Shouldn't be a problem. They're both in work for now.
Bollocks!
The property comprises a modern kitchen, utility room, a master bedroom with ensuite shower, three further bright bedrooms, and a garden.
Well.
Don't tell me. You're already imagining the
top-of-the-range kitchen blender.
And an espresso machine, a retro toaster in the corner there.
And a retro fridge as well. Yes. The whole room will be swimming in roses and jasmine. And there'll be delicious scented candles everywhere. And I'll be surrounded by plump red cushions, and there'll be classical music playing on my stereo.
And a bowl of Belgian chocolates on the table there.
And all the new friends I'll meet at antenatal classes. And all the presents I'll get at my baby shower. And I'll drink chilled pomegranate juice.
Yes. Waiting. Waiting for... I wonder what this room was before they turned it into a study.
Oh. Yes. I definitely want to get my husband around to see this one.
I think you're right. Hi, you must be the new guys from...
Shut up. Are you the fastest growing estate agency in the southeast?
No.
Then are you the manager of the flagship branch of the fastest growing estate agency in the southeast?
No.
No. You just hope to be employed by the manager of that flagship branch, don't you? So why the hell did I have to kick in the door to my new shop?
Yeah, sorry. I was showing a client around a property.
No. As from today, you're already tomorrow's yesterday's man. Got it?
Right.
Right. I'm Matt, your new manager, and this is my team. We're here to make over this backwater and turn it into yet another successful addition to the Collier Bryan chain.
Well, I'm Danny. I worked for Mr. Knightley for the last 2 years.
No wonder he sold out.
And new owners don't usually hang on to the old fixtures and fittings, do they?
Too right, darling. You're on probation. So three little words of advice. She is a bastard. He is a bastard. And she is a bastard.
Ooh.
So what does that make you?
The clue is who hired them. So what you got on the books? It's not bad. Ouch. Check this out, Mel. See if it's worth anything, sweetheart. Phoebe, you work the phones. John T, I want you on board.
Okay.
Bloody hell. What in the name of God's creation is this?
Well, the owner died suddenly, and there isn't even anyone to look after the cat, so,
What are you, the Taliban? This place is an outrage. It's an atrocity, it's a bloody bomb site. The stupid bloody cat! So I never want to see a pigsty like this in the collarbone's window again, all right?
What happened to the nice guy, Danny?
We thought you'd like to sell this place.
Oh.
Do you mind me asking why?
Well, I need the money for his nibs there.
Mum.
They're putting him to care.
Where would you live?
Well, that doesn't matter. Wayne needs some way to stimulate him. He can't spend the rest of his life stuck to this thing all day.
Look, without some sort of vibration, Wayne gets distressed. And then he gets angry. He was okay when he was a kid, but he's, doing his testosterone now.
What happens if you turn it off?
Oh, he goes back to being the Prime Minister.
The thing is, I'm going to have to show people around.
I know it's not easy, but you have to help us. We drown in here.
No.
You have my word. Collier Bryant will do everything that we possibly can for you.
Bloody cat.
What the shit? How come we're not selling that one?
Well, because Julian, the owner, didn't like my valuation.
Julian? You got turned down by someone called Julian?
Yeah.
Yeah? What kind of Nancy are you? Not even Julians get turned down by Julians.
So why didn't you overvalue it, you prat?
I was telling Julian the truth as I saw it.
The truth?
Now you're really scaring me. Who wants to hear truth from an estate agent? Huh?
You don't walk in and tell the punters their two-bedroom tip with a box room you couldn't fit a box in needs a new roof and windows, do you? Huh? You undisambiguate. Am I making myself clear?
Not in the least.
Exactly. You say it's a charming three-bedroom villa with period features and an inglenook fireplace.
Undisambiguate.
What, Mel? How'd you get on with that maze there?
Oh, just some scum mum looking to downsize from a council flat. Not gonna give a toss.
Oi, what do you call a 28-year-old scum mum?
Oh, please.
Granny. Oi, haven't you got a second viewing today?
Yeah?
Yeah, well, if you still want a job next week, seal it. And why aren't you wearing a suit?
Well, I've only got one proper suit. I like to wear it for special occasions.
What, like picking up your P45, you mean? So remember, two words, yeah? Undisambiguate. OK, hump some dumps to these chunks.
It's perfect. We can put an espresso machine in the kitchen and a real Victorian bath in the ensuite. Danny was telling me there's a tennis club just down the road.
What?
Well, they're bound to have squash courts, aren't they? Richard loves his squash. Always sneaking off for a game, aren't you? 3 or 4 times a week.
Not 3 times a week.
Yes, you do. And the club he belongs to is on the other side of town, so he's always getting stuck in traffic.
Hey, look, can we stick to the point here? Have you got a card or something?
Yeah.
And there's a study that'll make a perfect little nursery. Well, I like it. I really like it. What do you think?
Yes, well, it's, interesting. Ooh. Shit, look, I need to get back to the office. Can we talk about this later?
No, I don't want to lose this place. Why don't we put in an offer?
Now?
Please, darling.
Fine, whatever.
You don't want to buy this house, I promise you. This is not the house for you.
I think he's right.
And believe me, you do not want to have a baby with this man.
What are you talking about?
Because he doesn't want to have a baby with you.
What the...
How is this any of your bloody business?
Look, he's not playing squash 4 times a week. He's having an affair. So if you really want a baby, I think you should divorce him.
Come on, we're going. This guy's a madman. You, you'll pay for this. I promise you, your job is toast.
And you might want to check to see if he switched to a new brand of razor recently.
How dare you? How bloody dare you?
Sorry. When did we sell all the properties in the window?
We didn't.
Oh,
those spaces just to come on for vendors to make the place look busy.
And it panics buyers into buying.
You see, it's not just about belling and selling anymore. You've got to be proactive.
Don't you know anything about estate agency?
Clearly not.
Would you like a coffee, cappuccino?
No. He'll sell you this place for nothing if the price is right. Excuse me, sir. Excuse me.
Allow me.
Love. Thank you.
Who's that?
That is Steve from Social Services.
What does he want?
He's a respite worker. He's going to look after Wayne for a couple of hours while we go and look at a few places.
You organise this for me?
Well, you don't look like a woman who can act on impulse.
Just tell him not to touch my washing machine. Are you crazy? I can't afford a mansion.
No, of course you can't. But I thought you might like to see what's out there for Wayne. It specialises in the care of young adults. So there's a long waiting list, and to be honest, your local authority might not be willing to match the fees, but there's no harm in looking, is there? I thought we should look in on the music room.
Yeah, okay. This is it. But they're just like Wayne.
What did you expect? I mean, like you, they do their best here, but they can't work miracles. Well, I'm sorry, that's just the way it is. Money can't buy you a cure. You know that. So listen, if you want to take some time to think things through...
Excuse me? Think what through?
You know, about putting Wayne into a home and
Look,
stuff.
As well as being autistic, he's got a chromosomal abnormality. That's mental impairment, learning difficulties, hyperactivity, ADD, ADHD, emotional retardation and severe behaviour problems. Oh, not to mention anxiety and mood swings. So of course I've got to put him into a bloody home. Because I can't do nothing for him.
He said what to you? She should get a divorce.
That's actually
gone. Where's Danny?
Down, Wayne! Wayne! I told you I wasn't watching anything, you asshole! Get out of the house and take that useless up and shut with you!
So how's it going, Danny?
Yeah, a couple of appointments have been a bit tense.
I bet. I mean, not only do you try and break up a marriage, but you get a social worker to do over a spastoid. You do realise you work for commission, don't you?
10% the 3% charged by Collier Bryans.
What have you pulled down so far?
Nothing.
Yeah, big fat nothing. The two big fat zeros after it. I can't wait to see you at one of our Collier Bryans' big nights out.
Congratulations, Matt. Flagship branch. You see, there's always room for another thrusting, dynamic yes man at Collier Bryans.
Yes, boss.
Shut up.
Sorry, boss.
Come on then, hurry up.
Okay, now we get to the business end of the evening. In third place, I'm getting the Audi for 3 sales and 1,400 quid worth of commission. It is Nigel from Tuesday. In second place, I'm getting the 4x4. It is. Dazzling Darren from Dunford!
Yeah! I love you, Darren!
How much do you want to do? Oh, it's pretty little fishy. It's right.
Yes, congratulations. Who's got the Lotus this week?
Well, what do you know? The king of the bling. The star with the car. The ace of the place is me! So if any of you size zero ladies want to check out the suspension, you're welcome to a spin, Mel.
You're going to have to make at least another million before you can take that one on, Matt.
I never like to make a comment about my fellow negotiators, and I'm not going to make an exception for a bitch like her.
20.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, now the moment you've all been waiting for. Four.
Geek of the Week!
Come on, Danny boy! Don't get much much worse than this. So let's give this spanner a great big Colly O'Brien's turn.
Yes. Show him what we really think of him.
Well, I think you were all very mean to him last night. So I want to make it up to you. In any way I possibly can, because you look so cute on your hat. Like a darling little boy lost puppy, aren't you? Mm. There. Yummy mummy, make it all better.
Oi, get rid of that other board.
Yeah, I'll be there 5:30, so don't be late. Fine.
Good riddance to bad rubbish, eh, Julian?
Yeah, I don't know what the last agents were saying to the people they brought round, but they were put off before they even got through the front door.
Well, you see, I find that hard to believe, Julian. Your house is absolutely pristine. I can't believe it hasn't sold already.
Come on.
Wow. And that is not a word I ever use lightly, Julian.
Look, I'll tell you the truth.
The more truth you tell me, the fewer fancy adjectives we can put in your spec. I like to undisambiguate, Julian.
Undisambiguate, I see. Well, you're talking my language, but I need a quick sale. I've got a lot on at the moment, business-wise. I could do some cash flow, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, well, if there's property still on the market in a week, I'll eat that for sale sign on toast.
Well, in that case, you better have some keys. As I'm off to my bay for a few days.
Well, here's to a lucrative trip and an even more lucrative return. Oh, all right to bell through with any offers that come in.
You talk a good game.
Trust me, I'm an estate agent.
Lock it when you leave.
Get in!
You shouldn't say it's under offer. In fact, you shouldn't even be showing it at all. You stole this appointment from me.
Yeah, I did, didn't I? Kissy, kiss, kiss. Except do I look like the tea and sympathy type?
You must think you're pretty clever.
No, I just think you're ugly stupid. I mean, please. I don't honestly think I'd have any interest in some flat broke slacker living in a one-bedroom rented flat who spends all his sad evenings watching reruns of The A-Team.
Oh, you're good.
I'll digest.
But listen, if you really want to steal a property from me, I've got one that I just don't know what to do with.
You're telling me somebody actually lives here?
Yep.
Can we look inside?
Yeah, I've got a key.
I take it back. This is amazing. You're not up to this. You couldn't get the right buyers or the right price. This is a special sale.
No, I agree. I don't deserve it. I'm more the ex-local authority end of the market.
How long has the owner had this boat?
Well, he bought it 2 years ago through a family connection. His dad pulled it off the mud and renovated it.
So has the owner got kids?
No. No, he made that himself for a school project.
And he swore one day that he would make his boat his own.
Yeah, something like that.
Well, can understand the impulse. This is a total dream. So when do I get to meet the owner?
You just have.
What?
I'm looking for a quick sale.
Even though your dad did all this himself?
Yeah, it's time to move on, I think.
So why don't you just sell it yourself?
Oh, I don't know. A bit like living here, I suppose. Too many ghosts and memories.
But it's perfect. Really perfect.
Yeah, well, the only thing I still like about it is the view from the deck. There. Now, isn't that wonderful?
Yeah, it is rather spectacular. But what would you put in the spec? I mean, is it a panoramic vista of the harbour or more of a lock basin?
It's not my problem anymore.
Still, whatever it is. It'll add 10 grand to the asking price. Hey! Hey, what about me? Come back here, you total bastard!
But spot on about the A-team.
You're bluffing. Yeah, I know you're bluffing because you haven't got the balls to do this to me.
You were right.
What?
He's screwing his secretary.
I'm sorry.
Well, don't be. He's not. How did you know?
Well, men can be a bit lazy about personal grooming. So once they're married, they stop changing their brand of razor, but as soon as they're back out there again, they want the best a man can get, don't they? So it's an obvious clue. Like taking up squash.
The only thing he's squashing is her. She's fatter than me. She's uglier than me. She's got significantly smaller tits, but she doesn't want children, which apparently makes all the difference.
Well, for what it's worth, I think your husband's crazy.
Thank you. But, well, obviously, I won't be making an offer on the house that you showed me.
Yeah, of course, that's fine.
But I am definitely still in the market. I'm looking for a clean break, somewhere special I can start over again, from scratch.
I'm afraid you're going to have to talk to one of my colleagues.
I'd rather talk to you. Well, we've gone in a... Please. I want someone I can trust.
Thanks so much. I'll be in touch.
Yeah, you've got my... All right, how much have you got?
Only 400K now.
Okay. Right, I'll find you somewhere. Somewhere you can pour your heart into, I promise.
What a result! Look at this house! Dripping with taste. Clean lines, glass, chrome, Campari. Ready and waiting on a tray there.
Yeah, well, that's Julian's for you.
And anyone who buys it is laughing because this guy is bleeding desperate.
Yeah?
Yep. Complete front. Ooh. He's given it all that about temporary cash flow, but I know he's got his dick caught in the bacon slicer. So we'll take the first offer that comes his way.
Right, I'll have 15 clients here to view by tea time. Show them around in a group, get them bidding against one another.
No, you bloody won't.
Well, who do you want to show it to then?
Absolutely no one.
No, but it's all gone drastic on the plastic, man. I need my share of this commission.
Well, there won't be any. Because I'm having this little gem for myself. Oh.
What are you, Jonty? The cleaner? You need to grow some balls, mate.
What are you doing?
Well, if I'm going to sell this maisonette, I need to get a handle on the location.
You're taking the piss.
Coffee?
Let's face it. You could have gotten rid of Wayne any time in the last 16 years, no questions asked, so why didn't you?
Because he was mine.
Because you loved him?
Yeah.
So if you stop loving him now?
Look at him. Look at him.
He's gone right there.
Could you do that to somebody you love? Well, I can't. And that's why Wayne's going into...
Well, what if I found you an alternative? Somewhere that could work for both of you? I'll find you somewhere.
Yeah? What's in it for you?
3% commission. Plus, I don't want Wayne to end up hating his mum. The way I hate mine. Oh, yeah.
Hello, I thought I'd just help you.
You got shore leave then? Arch but fair.
Okay, well, have a look at
these.
Yeah, they're much more
simple. So, you met Julian?
And this place is not to be shown to anyone under any circumstances.
Bye.
Capiche?
So you can keep the commission for yourself?
None of your business.
Can I help
Phoebe? No, I'm afraid she's out right now. Yeah, no, I don't know when she'll be back. In fact, she's on holiday for a month. Yes, okay. Well, I'll be right there. Okay, bye.
Any calls for me, Melinda?
No, none at all. Look, I've got to pop out to the chemist. Could you man the phone for me?
Sure. Oh, but anything juicy comes through for you, it's mine.
That is the way it works, isn't it?
Where are you? Come on, Kat, it's me. I'm not going to kick you.
Push.
Hello, mate.
Oh, hey.
You haven't seen that cat about, have you?
Oh, man. Sorry, mate, I haven't seen it.
Oh, well, never mind.
It's not a late payment. In the post, it went first class yesterday, so please don't.
I want you to phone this through to my man, Julian, in Marbella.
Well, I don't care how desperate he is, he's never going to accept an offer this low.
Probably quicker to breed a carrier pigeon. Of course he's not going to accept it. He's not supposed to. It's not my offer anyway.
So, whose offer is it? Because I thought you said you didn't want anyone else to view the property.
I expect him to turn it down, you muppet. It's just there to make him panic. So he'll accept my not quite as low offer on his return.
So it's a fake offer.
Hello, Phoebe. These are
gonna... Yeah, the wheel's spinning, but the cage is empty. Everybody's gonna love today, gonna love today, gonna love today. Everybody's gonna love today, gonna love today. Any way you want to, any way you got to.
How'd you get in there? Oh, shit. Yeah, you're right. There is a little bit of curtain you haven't shredded.
Yeah? Cheers. Bye.
Oi! Is this bloody microphone on? I said no viewings.
Yeah, but when the vendor's away, I like to check to see if everything's all right.
What are you, social services? Get on with some real work.
All right, but I don't know what we'd say to the owner if anything happened.
His name is Julian.
So?
So, have you ever met a dangerous Julian? Huh? Julian Lennon? Julian Lloyd Webber? Julian Clary? St. Julian Norwich? I don't think so. Oh, please, don't hurt me, Julian. No, Julian, Julian, no! Don't break both my arms and my legs! Oh, Julian, please, don't cut both my knackers! Trust me. You don't get threatened by Julians.
If you say so.
No. Hey, what are you laughing at? Get back to work.
How do you fancy a new owner, eh? I want to show you an alternative.
Don't be stupid. I can't go nowhere without Wayne, and Wayne can't go nowhere anyway.
You want to bet?
Oh, hello, this is Phoebe from Polly Bryant.
Hi there.
Were you still thinking of settling down and having... Oh, I see. A nice young woman called Mel has been showing people around. No, that's lovely. Really, really lovely. Okay, thank you. Bye-bye. Hey, that is my follow-up.
Well, not anymore, it seems.
But I talked them up. I qualified them. I got all their details.
Yeah, thanks for that. It was lovely of you. Really, really lovely.
Bloody two-faced bitch.
Wow. Yeah, I know, stupid cat. When he's at me, he vibrates like an old boiler with a couple of gaskets blown.
And this is your alternative?
Yeah. So up on board before he stops purring.
Wayne?
Oh,
I don't believe it. What the bloody hell have you done to him?
Nothing. I just switched the pumps on so the whole boat's vibrating.
Mum!
Oh! Mum!
Oh! I feel it on the floor.
Yeah, it's like living in a giant washing machine.
Oh, Mum! I'd like you to meet my girlfriend, Dawn.
Mum!
Mum!
Yeah, right. Like I can afford somewhere like this.
Look, we can work something out, I promise you.
Don't be stupid, it's just another bloody wind-up.
No, it's not. I promise. Look, they're about the same price and the owner don't want this anymore. He's just looking for a quick sale.
Really?
Yeah. And if it's any help, I can throw in the cat as well.
You're not still worrying about that bloody cat, are you?
No. I found it at home.
Yeah? We want to try doing it with people sometime.
Hello, this is Phoebe Beecham from Collie Bryant's. Hi, hi. I'm just coming up to see you.
Have you been talking to my wife again?
Yeah.
Yeah, but listen, Kate didn't want to make an offer.
Well, I do.
What?
I can't stay at our old place either. Sophie doesn't like it.
Sophie?
My secretary. Well, girlfriend, I suppose. She thinks, you know, there are issues.
Yeah, I can see why there might be.
So, I want you to arrange another viewing for me.
Okay, let me get back to you. The kitchen.
Oh, it's awesome.
I told you so.
All right, if I wander a bit, get the vibe for myself.
Sure.
Well, it may not be a loft. But you're already imagining the perfect bachelor pad, aren't you?
Yeah. Sweet. This is where I'll put my 132 bottle wine coupe.
Hi, babes. I got you some Viagra. Because I want to christen every single room in this fabulous house. But only if my two lesbian friends can join up. Oh, Richard, it's great.
You really like it?
Yeah.
Make the call. I'll match the asking price.
Even take the size down for you.
I want to talk to you about that offer you phoned through.
Of course you do. But you didn't need to worry about that. We've got a jaunty to take them down.
Only it's a lot lower than I was hoping for.
Now, I know it's disappointing, Julian, very disappointing, but if you need a quick sale, what can you do?
But you've been showing people around, yeah?
Yeah, we haven't stopped. Have we?
No, there's been loads of viewings.
Oh, I'm very glad to hear it.
What's this, Julian?
You owe me £2,000 for industrial cleaning.
Don't know what you're talking about, Julian.
The whole place was covered in cat shit.
Well, that's impossible because no one's been anywhere near.
No. It's nothing to do with us. We don't know bollocks about no cats.
So, you can shove your offer, mind yourself. Exactly where I'm going to shove this board.
Oh, right, now that's Collier property.
Lovely.
Yeah, but I mean, come on now. Please, come on now. Please don't.
how it works, is it? My soon-to-be ex-husband gets the fabulous period house, and you try to pile me off with this dump.
Well, you said you wanted to make a clean break, start from scratch, and don't get much scratchier than this.
It could take years to sort out this mess.
Well, yeah, it'll be a challenge, but it's also an opportunity to really express yourself. You know, make something wholly and totally you. Let's have a look upstairs.
This place is much better.
No, in fact, it's worse.
How much worse?
Hi. Hi.
Oh, hello.
I saw your car outside. Any luck with the cat?
Yes, mate. Yeah, I found it a good home. Thanks for asking.
Hi. Are you the new neighbour?
This is my client, Kate Cornford.
Robinson. Kate Robinson.
Wait.
Ms. Robinson was just saying what a big job this would be for a single woman to take on by herself, alone.
It would, yeah, yeah. Well, I'm just next door, so if you need any help, feel free to give me a knock. I'm a dab hand with a paintbrush.
Thanks.
So, Ms. Robinson, what about this house, then?
Look, it's my maiden name, all right?
Yeah, of course it is. But you haven't answered my question.
I don't know.
I think you do.
So, just a little room upstairs left then.
So what am I going to do with that?
We could always make it into a nursery.
So, do you want another last look round, or can we go now?
Oh, sod it, I'll take it. I'm gonna get.
Right, calm down, Kiddywinks, calm down. And now, finally, in the top spot. This week's lucky winner of the Lotus, it's Danny Mays.
Looks like you underestimated him, Matt.
Ah, I didn't underestimate him, boss. He was just better than I thought, that's all.
Sorry about that, mate. Beginner's luck.
Yeah, will you look after my car, because I'll be having it back next week.
Parable for all new managers, eh? Prodigal son, maybe? Or a lost sheep returned to the flock?
Yeah, it's been a revelation, boss.
You can go flock yourself.
Right! Lucky Danny Mays there with his Lotus.
How did you manage to pull that one off?
Well, let's take a spin back to mine, and I'll tell you.
Right! Now, before I meet myself and the lovely ladies of Lewisham.
All right. What are we doing here?
I own it.
Jesus, you can't have bought this dump as an investment. Look, if you want to get on the buy-to-let market...
I don't. I swapped it.
For what?
Well, look at it this way. I don't need you to sell my barge for me anymore.
You cannot be serious.
Why not? Discounting the mooring, I've probably made a bit.
But that boat was a statement. What does this say about you?
It says, I think Matt's an arsehole. And I'm going to have his job.
No!
can sell houses in ways you can't even imagine. You might want to take notes.
No, Danny, I prefer to count them.
I really want to make love to you tonight.
What?
Now you have a go, Mel.
No, I might have to change my knickers if I wore any.
She hasn't shagged me. It's probably only a matter of time, though, eh?
So, ruthless people prepared to do anything. Well, how far will Janice be prepared to go for our live Bush Tucker trial as we're back with I'm a Celebrity next here? Well, on ITV2, Vince is in for a few shocks with his new movie in Entourage, and a drama starring Martin Sheen documents the presidency of Kennedy on ITV4.